Hi guys, I'm Jeremy Rennex, Head Teacher Technology, Cessnock High School. Really want to thank you for the opportunity to talk some IPT with you today. So we'll get started. I thought we could break this down into a number of components. So we're going to start with course outline. We'll talk a little bit about HSC exam formats. I've decided to take a multiple choice question and a short answer question from each of the core topics, and we'll talk some of those. And then we'll talk exam preparation and resources. So the IPT course is divided into three core topics: project management, worth 20%, information systems and databases, also worth 20%, and communication systems, 20%. Then you have a couple of option strands that usually your teacher selects for you. There's transaction processing systems, decision support systems, automated manufacturing, and multimedia. Transaction processing systems and multimedia are probably the most common of those. And it's important that you only attempt two of those option topics when it comes to the HSC exam, and only the ones that you study. There's sometimes a temptation to attempt something that you haven't studied. My suggestion would be to steer clear of that. So the HSC exam is the same structure every year, so you can be guided by past HSCs when it comes to this. It's important to note that there are three sections, and you have to attempt each one of those sections. Section one is multiple choice, worth 20 marks, 20 questions, and it says allow around about 40 minutes of that section. Be guided by that. If you're still working on section one after an hour, you know you need to move on. Section two, short answer on your core topics, questions 21 to 24, worth 40 marks. Once again, be guided by around about the hour and 10 minutes that they suggest. And section three is those option topics that we were talking about. Attempt two of the four, worth 40, about an hour and 10 minutes. It's a 3-hour exam and there's 5 minutes reading time allocated. Please use your reading time effectively. Take the time to read through the questions, get in your head the concepts that will be examined and move forward. So the structure's always the same. Use those past HSCs as a guide, and when it comes to attempting the questions, make sure you read the questions carefully. I suggest to my guys to regularly underline or highlight key terms and phrases, and even make notes on the examination paper if you need to. So the multiple choice section, you can try and rule out some incorrect options. Usually there's at least one option which is pretty much off track. I suggest to my guys to cross out those incorrect options and move on. Short answer questions, they're always, almost always, scenario driven. And it's really important that you understand the scenario, really get your head around the scenario, and then be able to relate your knowledge to the scenario. It's important to look at some exam trends. So you can look at past HSCs and try and identify content that's been regularly examined. For example, and I just picked this off the top of my head, a concept like SQL has been examined very regularly. And note in the more recent exams a trend towards Web 2 technologies. So let's get started. We'll get stuck into some content. You would have seen this diagram regularly during your preliminary course. And in some recent HSC exams, the markers have gone back to these diagrams. In an exam a couple of years ago, most questions were related to these diagrams. So it's important that we go back to our preliminary course stuff and have a look. So you would have seen these diagrams regularly in your preliminary course with the information processes listed: collecting, organizing, analyzing, storing and retrieving, etc. You may have had an acronym for that: Common All Students, Pat the Dog. There's many of them. But just go back to your preliminary course and have a look over those information system diagrams.